cannot wait to give thanks and praises to God. At times you may think that I'm strange when I call out my Jesus name. It's just another way to give.
And now our Juneteenth celebration.
Those rebels who left the Union didn't want to be troubled with the freedom of our ancestors. And even in the entire state of Virginia, this action was not fully completed with the freeing of slaves until April of 1865. But we celebrate this date, June 19, 1865, that declares freedom be given to every human being who is still alive and enslaved on American soil. So, by order given, in the last state, Texas, on that day, the Union General Gordon Granger made sure that the order number 3 was signified. In accordance with the proclamation from the Executive of the United States, all slaves are free. This involves an absolute equality of personal rights and personal property between former masters and former slaves. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17 says, now the Lord is spirit, and where the spirit of the Lord is, there is
and if you don't want to be thrown in jail, For breaking the law, you let these slaves go. Now.
All right? Get off my property! And don't come crawling back to me when you find out you've been hoodwinked! Go!
The master have a mind, but not a heart have my mind, but have my body, but not my mind.
That's right.
He don't have my
soul breaker. Just pray,
God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Okay, here's the reality. You can never be free with a slave mentality.
Come on, man.
You fear the words of the cross burner. You ignored the words of Nat Turner. And you forgot the words of Sojourner. Now that's the truth. You can no longer be confined, not by the chains on your wrist, but by the chains on your mind. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is abundance of freedom. But you have to open up your mind's eyes so that you can see Him. Even though Joseph was a slave, his mind was free. His gift created a shift that gave him total liberty. Whom the Son set free is free indeed. Now that's a promise from God, and that's all that you need. Now freedom is in your hands, whether it's in prayer or in a fix. But the worst freedom of all that causes most of us to fall is the freedom that we missed.
Say we.
Keep on moving. The gospel train is a steady coming. Gotta keep on moving. Keep on moving.
Gumbo Step started in South Africa. It originated in the coal mines. The miners could not speak to each other at all, so they used stomping to communicate with each other. I'll give you an example. We were called to be free. Bloodline, speak!
Galatians chapter 5, verse 13. You, my brothers and sisters, were called to be free, but do not use your freedom to indulge the flesh. Rather serve one another humbly in love.
Our fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that will spread to us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, fabulous? Actually, who are you not? You are a child of God. Your plain small does not serve you. There's nothing in light and shrink so that other people can do it. We are all meant to shine as children. We were born to make
today, as we go about our dead lives, there are cries to save those from a modern day slavery. Children, teens, women and men are being snatched into sex slavery right before our very eyes. We know at least 100,000 children have been bought and sold for sex in the United States each year. Just like our enslaved ancestors, these human beings are being faced with unimaginable atrocities today.
Attention to our epic visionary spotlight.
In case you don't understand, when you see me stand and clap my hands, it's just my way to give thanks and praises to God. At times you may think that I'm strange when I call out my Jesus name. It's just another way to give praises to Him.
I'm so thankful, yes I am. Give Him praise whenever I can.
Thankful for doing all the things you do. Lord, I'll keep on showing you.
I'm so thankful, yes I am.
Yes, I will.
Give Him praise whenever I can.
Grateful for everything that you've done. See me lifting my hands up to thee. It's just my way to show that I'm grateful to God. At times you may hear me saying over and over and over again how much I really love the Lord. I'm grateful to
I'm so thankful, yes I am.
holding my hands up to thee. It's just my way to show that I'm grateful to God. At times you may hear me sing over and over and over again how much I really love the Lord. I'm grateful to
shall not be doomed to repeat it. We shall always live in the triumph of our freedom. Our victory has come through Christ Jesus, and it shall be sustained through Christ Jesus. Remember to never live in fear, but in victory, and that is freedom. I leave you with this poem by Marianne Williams. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness.